Hello everyone, welcome to session 17 of LTEC 623 Digital Video Design. This short video is designed to wrap up LTEC 623 and send you off in style. We'll do that by briefly recapping what we've covered this semester, revisiting the course learning objectives, and sharing a few ideas for possible next steps. So let's get started. So what have we accomplished this semester? Well, we started out by situating video within the larger context of education. This distinction allowed us to separate digital video theory from education theory, paving the way for us to move back and forth between these two important perspectives. We learned about the different dimensions of video-based learning, acknowledging that while powerful, video is not a silver bullet for teaching and learning. That said, we did learn that video has a number of advantages that make it an effective medium for sharing information and ideas. As we prepared to create our own videos, we learned about the ideas behind do-it-yourself media and participatory culture. From there, we studied lighting and built our own do-it-yourself studios. Technically, we learned about camera shots, camera movements, and camera angles, and we introduced the independent dimensions of video: production style, visual aesthetics, and production value. We also explored how these dimensions combine to define and influence educational video. We then embarked on a three-stage production process, moving us from pre-production planning to production filming and ending with post-production editing and sharing. During this process, we learned about new tools like WeVideo and WeView, and in the final weeks of the semester, we examined various research investigating what does and does not matter when it comes to designing effective instructional videos. And finally, we ended by looking at examples of how video is being used to support education in five different ways. And that, my friends, is the semester in a nutshell. So what about our learning objectives? Let's take a minute to review those objectives so we can contemplate how well we did in terms of meeting them. Our first learning objective was to understand, analyze, and evaluate how people learn with, from, and through video. The second learning objective was to understand and apply various pedagogical approaches to teaching with and through video. The third objective was to understand and apply aesthetic and communicative principles of video design and production. And the fourth and final objective was to create original digital videos for instructional purposes. Looking back, I hope you feel the course content and activities aligned with and helped us meet these objectives. And importantly, that we were able to move up and down all the levels of Bloom's taxonomy. To end, I want to share a few ideas about where you might go from here. First, I want to encourage you to keep reading research on video and education. In all likelihood, as video becomes more and more a part of society in and out of education, the amount of research related to educational video will only increase. So, if you're interested, I encourage you to keep an eye on this research and the questions that the field is addressing. Here's a list of popular educational technology journals based on Google Scholar's citation counts. These are good places to start in terms of monitoring research on video and teaching and learning. I've highlighted a few journals here that I think are particularly well regarded. Second, I want you to consider learning more about digital storytelling. This is something we didn't really have time to get into this semester, but I think it's relevant and important in education. There's a lot written about the power of using media education to help people of all ages develop their critical thinking and literacy skills through digital storytelling. For example, you might want to check out this book here by Stephen Goodman, the executive director of the Educational Video Center. Third, consider taking other video-related courses within the UH system. UH is huge, and one of the benefits of studying at a major state university is the buffet of course offerings. Take advantage. In terms of video, there's relevant courses in communication, the Academy for Creative Media, Information and Computer Science, and Educational Psychology. The courses listed here are more or less directly related to video, but all almost certainly will strengthen your understanding and ability to leverage and study educational video. Fourth, keep growing your affinity spaces by leveraging resources and events from groups like YouTube's Creator Studio. They have tons of learning resources and classes available for free, so be sure to check them out. Finally, keep an eye on developments in video technology. This is an area that is changing fast, and there are some exciting new technologies on the horizon. One example is 360-degree video, which has tons of potential for teaching and learning applications. Of course, each of these new developments will need to be researched in terms of its ability to enhance or hinder learning. So with each new development, there comes lots of potential research topics. Those are five different ways you might think about continuing your journey with educational video. All right, everyone, we're out of time for this semester. Thank you to all of you for your hard work and enthusiasm. I enjoyed working with you all as we explored the fascinating and timely area of digital video. Mahalo, everyone. Have a great holiday season and keep in touch.